Hello, in this quick tutorial I'm going to go over mineral groups and how we group them based on their chemistry. So the first thing that we want to know is that there are a couple major groups of minerals and we group them based on the elements that are present within them. And to figure that out, how you would do it, you basically are going to look at each mineral's chemical formula. And it's important to remember that minerals, by definition, have a very consistent chemical formula. They're going to bring the same elements together in the same ways every single time to create the different minerals that we see. Now the major mineral groups, I'm going to list them out and I'm going to tell you the elements that you're going to look for in their chemical formulas to figure out if they belong in that group. Now the first group, the biggest one of all, are the silicates. Okay, so these are the minerals that have silica and oxygen. So SI and O, and it looks like my kids are playing with my markers, so let me grab a new one. Hopefully that will work a little better. Another group that we have are the oxides. Okay, so this occurs when you have an oxygen that's going to be combining with a metal. Okay, so an example of a silicate that you have in your mineral box would be quartz. Okay, so sample number 15, if you have our lab kit. Now this is just made of silica and oxygen, SiO2. Okay, another silicate mineral that you have is biotite. It's darker in color. Okay, this is sample number 1 if you have the lab kit. This one is very flat and platy, but if you look at its chemical formula, it does have a silicon and an oxygen in it. Okay, now an oxide, we're going to be looking for oxygen and a metal. So an example that we have, hold on quickly, would be hematite. I think I forgot to pull it out. Okay, so sample 7. Okay, so this is iron and oxide. That's the only two elements in this chemical formula. So the iron is the metal and then the oxygen makes it an oxide. Okay. Another group that we have are the sulfates. So what we're going to be looking for is the sulfate ion. So sulfur and oxygen, SO4. And an example that we have for that one would be gypsum. So sample number 5. Okay. And this mineral is very soft. You can scratch it with your fingernail. It has a hardness of 2. But again, it has that sulfate ion inside of it. And that's going to be what makes it a sulfate mineral. So gypsum for that one. Okay, the next one that we have are the sulfides. Okay, so these are going to be minerals that have just sulfur and a metal. It doesn't matter what the metal is. If you're trying to tell the difference between a sulfate and a sulfide, when you look at the chemical formula, if you have sulfur and no oxygen, it's going to be a sulfide. So an example, let's see, we have galena as an example. So sample number 3, whoops, this galena is made of a lead sulfide, so Pb would be the metal, and S, that's sulfur. Another example that you have is sample number 14. Let's see, get in front of the camera. This is your pyrite, okay? And so this is FeS2, okay? So pyrite is also a sulfide mineral. The next group we have are the carbonates. I'll try for another color to see if it shows up. So carbonates are going to have a C, carbonate ion. So carbon, which is your C, and your oxygens are going to make it a carbonate. So the example would be calcite, sample number 2 from your box. This sample is CaCO3, so it has carbon and oxygen, and that's what makes it a carbonate. Okay, native elements, I'm going to list those down here. Native elements have single elements in them. So the example that we have in our lab kit is sample number 4, and this is our graphite. Now if I just draw I'm kind of drawing my hand with it. It's very soft. This is made of carbon and only carbon, so it's the only element in the entire chemical formula. If you see one element and nothing else, it's a native element. Another example would be a diamond. It's also made of just carbon, but it's formed in a different way under higher temperature and pressure. It has a different chemical structure, which makes it a different mineral, even though the two, graphite and diamonds, have the same chemical formula. Both, again, are native elements. All right, the last one that we have, I'm going to write down here, are the halides. Okay, these usually have the element fluorine or chlorine, Cl. And an example that you would have would be fluorite. It has fluorine in it. That would make it a halide. Now, in the activity that we're doing, we're trying to identify if something is a silicate mineral. So if it has Si, silicon, and oxygen, it would make it a silicate. If it's light in color, like, where did it go? Our calcite, so whites, light pinks, clear, these would be non-iron-bearing silicates. They don't have any iron or magnesium in them. Some of our silicates are dark in color, like our biotite. That's because it has magnesium and iron in it, giving it the dark color. So that would be an MgFe-bearing silicate, so iron or magnesium-bearing silicate, darker in color. Still, both silicate minerals. Okay, oxides are another important mineral group that we're going to look at. Again, just remember, it has oxygen, but no silicon. Okay, so oxygen in that middle makes it an oxide. The other one that will be standing out in this activity are the carbonates. Okay, so again, if it has carbon and oxygen, it's going to be a carbonate. And then all of these other groups, the sulfates, the sulfides, native elements, and halides today for this activity are going to be grouped together as an other. If you have any questions on mineral groups and how we group them together, again, look at the chemical formula, which is typed out for you. Figure out if it has silicon, oxygen, it's a silicate. If it has oxygen but not silicon, it's going to be an oxide. If it has carbon and oxygen, it's a carbonate. And if it doesn't have any of those, it doesn't fit in those three categories, it's an other for this activity. If you have any other questions, just let me know.